Hello everyone, this is Saravanan, Professor Department of Mechanical Engineering, Erode Sengunthan Engineering College, Pudupudi, Erode. Here in this video, we can see in detail about non-ferrous materials and its applications. In this non-ferrous materials, aluminium is one of the category of non-ferrous material. Aluminium is a light metal and easily machinable. It has a wide variety of surface finish. So because aluminium, because of these properties, aluminium looks, aesthetic look of aluminium, it's look likes better to other ferrous materials. Ferrous materials contain iron is the prime constituents of the material. So because of that iron, cast iron, presence of iron, the non-ferrous materials, ferrous materials aesthetic look is very ugly. When compared to ferrous materials, non-ferrous materials is looks like better. So because of that, copper looks, aesthetic look of copper is better. Aluminium look is better because of its surface finish. So aluminium possesses very good electrical and thermal conductivity, and aluminium have a highly reflective to heat and light. Aluminium is a versatile metal. So because of this versatile property, the aluminium can be easily castable, easily rollable, easily stampable, and easily drawn into any shape and size, easily spun into another material, and it having a roll forming property. And because of this versatile material property, aluminium is able to hammer, aluminium is able to extrude, and it can easily forge into many shape and size. So because of this excellent properties, aluminium is a vital role in using all other non-metallic materials. It have a highly reflective to heat and light, and aluminium can be easily reverted, and aluminium can be easily welded, aluminium can be easily brassed, and it should be resin bonded also. And aluminium possesses very good corrosive resistance, and this kind of corrosive resistive property, aluminium is a no productive coating needed. Aluminium does not needed a productive coating, so it's already looks like better when compared to other non-metallic materials and metallic materials, ferrous and non-ferrous materials. So because of this corrosive resistance property, it does not need any coating, and because of non-corrosive resistance, but however it can be often anodized to improve the surface finish. Because of improving the surface finish and because of appearance, we have to provide a non-productive coating. And when we go into the aluminium and its alloys, aluminium possesses high strength to weight ratio when compared to high strength low alloy steels, HSLA steels. The aluminium possesses high strength to weight ratio, that is high specific weight. Because of this high strength to weight ratio, it owing to high, that is low density also. Because of its aluminium and aluminium alloys, we can use this high strength to weight ratio property. We can use this aluminium in aircraft applications. So we need a high strength but low weight, then only we can able to fly using this kind of material. So because of this property, the aluminium mainly used in aircraft and its applications, aerospace applications. So such a material that is widely used in aerospace and automobile applications. In automobile also, we need a lightweight but high strength material. So because of lightweight and high strength, we are using this kind of aluminium materials in a fuel saving properties. We are using automobile also. So because of aluminium are widely used in aerospace and automotive applications, where weight savings are needed to better fuel efficiency and better performance. And aluminium lithium alloy are lightest among all aluminium alloys, and to find a wide applications in aerospace industry. When we look into the aluminium alloys are classified into two category, that is cast alloy and wrought alloy. Wrought alloys can be either heat treatable or non-heat treatable. And aluminium alloys are designed to by a 4-digit number. And this wrought aluminium alloys, the first digit of wrought aluminium alloy, the digit indicates the major alloying element. And cast, that is last digit after the decimal, that indicates product from casting. That is, casting is 0, ignote is 1. So this is classification of aluminium alloys, that is wrought alloy as a cast alloy. In this wrought alloy, the principal alloying elements are minimum number of aluminium, that is 99% aluminium, and other alloying elements are copper, manganese, silicon, magnesium and silicon, zinc and other elements. So in this, principal alloying elements are aluminium, that is as a casting one, casting aluminium alloy, principal alloying elements are aluminium 99% and also greater than 99% and copper, silicon, silicon with copper and magnesium, unused series of magnesium, zinc, titanium and other elements are used to create a aluminium alloys. And as a temper designations, we can go for solution heat treatment process, that is heating a single phase region and isothermal holding process. So here F is fabricated as the products in which thermal heat treatments, we need a thermal heat treatment process, and H is strain hardened, that is for use, that is used for wrought aluminium alloys, and H1 is the strain hardened only, that is strain hardened without thermal heat treatment needed, and O is the annealing and also recrystalline process, and T is the thermally treated with or without strain hardened to produce a stable tempering process other than F, H and O, and T3 is the solution heat treated then cold work. The composition and properties of some aluminium alloys. So this is aluminium association number, that is 1100, that is composition weight percentage of 0.12 carbon, condition is annealed, ultimate tensile strength is 35 MPa and ultimate tensile strength is 90 MPa and yield strength is 35 MPa and percentage of annihilation is 45. So these kind of aluminium alloys are used in food and chemical equipments, heat exchangers, light reflectors, etc. And AL association number, that is T003, that contains composition of 0.12 copper, 0.12 manganese, 0.1 zinc, condition is annealed, is having possessing the properties of 40 MPa yield strength, 110 MPa ultimate tensile strength and 30 elongation limit, that is used in utensils, pressure vessels and pipings. And likewise 5052, that is strain hardened condition, 2.5 magnesium and 0.25 chromium, that is composition, and strength wise that is 470 MPa ultimate tensile strength and 325 MPa of yield strength and percentage of elongation is 20. That is, these kind of aluminium alloys used in aircraft structure, rivets, truck wheels and screws. And aluminium association number, that is 2024, that is process is heat treated and composition are 4.4% copper, 1.5% magnesium, 0.6 manganese, that is yield strength 325 MPa and ultimate tensile strength 470 MPa and percentage of elongation is 20, that is used in aircraft structure, rivets, truck wheels and screws. And aluminium association number, that is 6061, that is 1% manganese, 0.6 silicon, 0.3 copper and 0.2 chromium are the alloying elements, and this is used in trucks, railroad cars, furnitures and pipelines. And 7075, composition weight percentage of 0.6% zinc and 2.5% manganese, 1.6 copper and 0.23 is chromium, that is packaged condition. And these are the properties of ultimate tensile strength, elongation and percentage of elongation. There is applications of these kind of aluminium alloys are aircraft structures and other highly loaded applications. So likewise, so these are the composition, condition and properties and applications of some alloying elements. So this aluminium association number, that is 359, there is composition of 7% silicon and 0.3% manganese, that is used in aircraft parts, automotive transmission cases, cylinder blocks. That is number is 8090, and composition of aluminium alloys like 2% lithium, 1.3% copper, 0.9% magnesium and 0.12% zirconium. That is yield strength is 360 megapascal, ultimate tensile strength is 465. So this kind of aluminium alloys is used in damage tolerant aircraft structures. And next we go for non-ferrous element, that is titanium. Titanium has a highly affinity to oxygen, and also it act as a strong deoxidizer, and titanium can catch fire and cause severe damage. Pure titanium melt at the temperature of 1670 degrees Celsius, and has a aluminium titanium has a low density of 0.4.51 gram per cubic centimeter, and it's look like titanium is 40% lighter than steel and 60% heavier than, but 60% heavier than aluminium. Titanium possesses excellent corrosion resistance due to the presence of a protective thin oxide surface film, and titanium can be used as a biomaterial, and titanium can be used in elevated temperature components, and there is some limitation is there. Pure titanium is lower its strength, and alloying is done to improve pure titanium. So that's why we go for a titanium alloy. So titanium, applications of titaniums are aircraft, in the aircraft side, titanium is used as a body structure, engine components, and supporting equipment side, it's using as a chemical processing industries, turbine engine parts, valve and pump components, marine hardware, and in the biomedical and medical applications, titanium is used as medical implants, and titanium is recently used in titanium bikes and automotive components. And also titanium can also cast by using the vacuum surface also. Because of titanium possesses high strength to weight ratio, and titanium having an excellent corrosion resistance, titanium is used the wide variety of applications. And pure titanium we cannot used for more applications, that's why we go for a titanium alloys, because pure titanium exhibits two phases, that is hexagonal alpha phase at room temperature and body centered cubic structure beta phase at above 882 degrees Celsius. So because of this property we go for a titanium alloy. The strength of titanium that can be improved using alloying. So alloying elements are either alpha or beta stabilizer. So we can add an alloying element to improve the strength of the titanium. Alloying elements with electron atoms ratio, and this is the alpha stabilizer. That is alpha stabilizer alloying elements like aluminium, and beta stabilizer alloying like vanadium and molybdenum. And we can use the both alloying elements to obtain the better properties of titanium. And alpha alloys have low density, moderate strength, reasonable ductility and group very good creep resistance. So when we use these kind of alloying elements to improve the titanium strength and properties of the material. So these are the some composition applications of titanium alloys. So this is the alloy type. Alloy type is CP titanium, that contains composition of 99.1% titanium. It possesses 414 megapascal yield strength and 484 megapascal ultimate tensile strength, and percentage of elongation is 45. So these kind of titanium alloys are used to make aircraft skins, marine and chemical processing equipments. And alloy type is alpha. This is unyield condition. So these are the composition, weight percent, that is titanium and zinc, Myself Saravanan, working as a professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Erode Secondary Engineering College, Tirupati, Erode. Here in this video, we can see about non-ferrous metallic materials. They are materials that consist of, based on the properties and applications, we classify into ferrous and non-ferrous material. Ferrous materials having iron content and non-ferrous does not having iron content. Name itself, it shows that it contains ferrous and it contains non-ferrous. So that is called ferrous and non-ferrous materials. In this non-ferrous materials category, we call it as, there are some kind of materials, that is aluminium, copper, nickel, and aluminium alloys, copper alloys, nickel alloys, nickel alloys, etc. In this category, here we can talk it about nickel. Nickel is a very good high strength metal and will have an excellent ductility and excellent corrosive resistance property and having a high temperature properties. It's having a nickel possesses high strength and high density material. And because of this unique properties, it include its excellent catalytic property also. And nickel have a catalyst for neon cells, fuel cells. In this fuel cells, nickel cobalt is seen as a low cost substitute for platinum catalyst. So this 2/3 of all kind of nickels that produced go into the category of stainless steel production. Also nickel is used extensively in an electroplating applications for various parts of wide variety of applications used in electroplating applications. And some kind of nickel and nickel based super alloys are having a very good class of materials having good high temperature in strength, grip and oxidation resistance. Because of this kind of properties, nickel is used in very high temperature applications like turbine engines. In this, nickel are used in safe memory alloys also. Safe memory alloys means they have a inbuilt memory that can change into the based on the applications that could be act as a alloy. And nickel based nickel titanium and nickel containing copper aluminium nickel, that is that kind of safe memory alloys that can go back to the original form, that is are an important class of engineering materials that safe memory alloys finding widespread use in many applications. That nickel containing materials that very much used in building and infrastructure facilities and chemical production, communications and energy based applications. These kind of safe memory alloys that can used in environmental production, food preparation, water treatment and transportation properties. And nickel based nickel cadmium, nickel metal hydrides that are used in applications like batteries also. So these are the some kind of nickel based applications, that is this 12%, that is stainless steel, non-ferrous alloys, electroplating and other applications, and also it is used in other alloying additions in steels also, turbine engines, electroplating, batteries. So these kind of applications that is used in nickel, nickel alloys. Next, non-ferrous material category, that is magnesium. Magnesium, when compared to other non-ferrous materials, magnesium is a lightest among commonly used metals. Melting point of magnesium is 650 degrees Celsius. It possesses a hexagonally closed pack structure. It possesses atomic structure is HCP structure, that is hexagonally closed pack structure. Magnesium is very reactive and is ready to combustible in air also. And magnesium can be used as a fire starter. Thermal conductivity is less than aluminium and pure magnesium has very good atmospheric resistance and moderate in strength. Magnesium possesses improved sustainability for when compared to alloying elements, and magnesium having a favorable atomic size, and magnesium alloys are easily casted and easily wrought. Wrought alloys are available in rod, bar, seat, plate, forging and extrusions. Magnesium alloys, when we add some alloying elements to magnesium, it would have a very good impact strength, resistance, corrosive resistance, and magnesium having good damping capacity and effective for high speed applications also. Due to its light weight when compared to aluminium, magnesium having superior machinability and ease of casting, magnesium and magnesium alloys are used in wide variety of applications, like when we producing a automobile components, when we manufacturing a sporting components, power tools. Magnesium alloys are used in aerospace equipments. Magnesium alloys are used in many kinds of fixtures. Magnesium alloys are used in electronic gadgets, producing electronic gadgets, and some kind of magnesium alloys are used in producing material handling equipments also. When compared to other ferrous and non-ferrous alloys, magnesium alloys are used in automotive applications like gearboxes, valve covers, alloy wheels, clutch housing, and brake pedal products. And these are the some of the composition properties and applications of some magnesium alloys. Based on the ASTM number, American Society for Testing of Materials, that is AZ31B, that is composition of this kind of alloy is 3% aluminium, 1% zinc, and 2% manganese. This possesses 200 yield strength, 200 megapascal of yield strength, 262 megapascal of ultimate tensile strength, and percentage of elongation is 15. So these kind of magnesium alloys are used in structure and tubing, cathodic production. And another ASTM number, that is HK31A, and composition is 3% thorium, 6%, 0.6% zirconium, and it condition of this magnesium alloy is strain hardened, and 200 megapascal of yield strength, 255 megapascal of ultimate tensile strength, and percentage of elongation is 9. This kind of magnesium alloys is used in high temperature applications like 315 degree Celsius. And ASTM number of ZK60A, it composition of 5.5 zinc and 0.45 zirconium, that possess ultimate tensile strength of 350 megapascal and yield strength of 285 megapascal, and it having a percentage of elongation of 11. And applications of these kind of magnesium alloys, that is used in forging of maximum strength for aircrafts. And the case of cast alloys, there is composition of 0.9 aluminium, 0.15 magnesium, and 0.7 zinc, and this is 150 megapascal of yield strength, 230 megapascal of ultimate tensile strength, and 3% of elongation. It can be used in die casting components, automobile components, luggage, and electronic devices. And the another magnesium alloys that can be used in automobile wheels and die casting parts that require very good reed strength. So these are the some properties, composition, and applications of magnesium alloys. When we look into the categories of non-ferrous materials, that is ceramic materials. Ceramic is a bond stuff material, clay, bathroom ware, that is cooking utensils, and these kind of materials are comes under the category of ceramic. Ceramic may be classified into refractory material, abrasives, glass, and advanced ceramics and engineering ceramics also. These kind of materials are bond stuff clay material. So ceramic is a bond stuff, that is Greek and word, we can call it as a ceramic, derived from Greek word. These classified into ceramics are classified into refractory materials, abrasives, glass, and advanced ceramics. And these kind of refractory ceramic materials are retains its strength at high temperatures. So its ceramics may possess, it could be used in a high temperature applications. must be chemically, physically stable at high temperatures. Ceramic materials must be stable in high temperatures. And it need to be resistant to thermal shock, should be chemically inert, and ceramic have a specific range of thermal conductivity and thermal expansion. Ceramic materials are used in linings for furnaces and crucibles, and also ceramic materials are used in reactors. Aluminium oxide, silicon oxide, calcium oxide, magnesium oxide and fire clay are used to manufacture the refractory materials. And one kind of ceramic material that is called zirconia, that is also used in extremely highly elevated temperatures. Silicon carbide and carbon like kind of ceramic materials are used in some very severe temperature conditions, and these kind of silicon carbide cannot be used in oxygen environment because of they will oxide and burn because of these kind of ceramic materials used in oxide environment. So some composition and types of some of the refractory materials types are fire clay, high alumina fire clay, silica and chrome ore. So these are the compositions. Composition percentages like aluminium oxide Al2O3, silicon oxide is SiO2, magnesium oxide MgO, chromium oxide, ferrous oxide, calcium oxide, titanium oxide. Al2O3, SiO2, magnesium oxide MgO and chromium oxide Cr2O3, Fe2O3, ferrous oxide, calcium oxide CaO and titanium oxide TiO2. So this is the percentage of prosperity. So these are the some common refractory materials used in ceramic world. And when we go for the kind of advanced ceramics are used in automobile components that operate at high temperatures, high efficiency, low frictional losses. It's having a minimum frictional loss and operate without a cooling system. When we operate in an automobile engine component, it does not need any cooling system, and lower weight than when compared to current engine when we use now. And some of the advanced ceramics used in automobile components, disadvantages are ceramic materials are very brittle. They possess high strength and used in highly elevated temperatures, but ceramic materials are brittle materials. It is difficult to remove internal voids. Some voids or cracks, some holes are produced at the time of production, so that cannot be removed. So that's why ceramic parts are difficult to form, and also it does not machine. So potential materials used in automobile components are Si3N4, that is used in engine valves, ball bearing, silicon carbide SiT, SiC, that is used in MES, FETS, and zirconium oxide ZrO2, it is mainly used in sensors. So possible engine components like engine block, piston coatings. So these are the some kind of advanced ceramics that is used in automobile engine components. These are the advantages and limitations when we use in automobile components. Next kind of material that is called MEMS, that is microelectromechanical system. So these micron-sized structures such as beams, cantilevers, diaphragms, valves, plates, switches that can function as a tiny sensors and actuators. That microelectrochemical mechanical system that can be fabricated by integrated circuit manufacturing process, that is bulk and surface micro machining. Thousands of micro machines that can be fabricated on a single silicon wafer with supporting circuits, that is called IC chips, that can be mass produced in the millions in the lowest prices. And low cost commercial micro electromechanical system devices developed for the following purpose, like corrosion detectors and monitors instrumentation for automotive.
Hello everyone, this is Saravanan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Erode Sengundar Engineering College, Tudupathi, Erode. Here in this video, we can talk about non-ferrous materials. There are, in universe, there are wide variety of materials available. Materials are classified into ferrous materials and non-ferrous materials. Ferrous materials are having an iron content. Name itself it shows that ferrous component, that is iron is the prime constituent of a material, and non-ferrous materials does not having the iron content. Iron does not having a prime constituent. So that is called, that is non-ferrous material. So here ferrous material. This micro electromechanical system, MEMS. MEMS comes under non-ferrous materials. It name itself, it shows that micro means small. So small sized structures that are call it as beams, cantilevers, diaphragms, valves, plates and switches that can be used as a function as a tiny sensors and actuators. So in this category of tiny sensors and actuators, we can use it as the MEMS, that is micro electromechanical system. This micro electromechanical system that is fabricated by integrated circuit, that is IC, that is fabricated by integrated circuit manufacturing process, that is bulk and surface micro machining. And there are n number of micro machines that can be manufactured on a single silicon wafer with the aid of circuits integrated on this particular chip. So these kind of materials are produced in the mass production. And micro electromechanical system is a low cost commercial devices that can be also developed. Examples: corrosion detector and monitor micro electromechanical system, instrumentation for automotive and aerospace applications, and biological and medical devices, chemical and environmental sensors, manufacturing process control devices, and nowadays micro electromechanical system that can be used in virtual reality system also. And one kind of abrasive ceramic. This ceramic is the burnt stuff material that can be, ceramic name is coined from burnt stuff, that is Greek word ceramics. These kind of abrasive ceramics that can be used in cutting tools and grinding tools. And one kind of abrasive ceramic that is diamonds. Diamonds are naturally available and synthetic also available. Diamonds are materials are also used as abrasives because of its relatively expensive. In industrial, diamonds are very hard and thermally conductive, and diamonds are unsuitable as the gemstone that are used in industrial diamonds. Common abrasives are silicon carbide, aluminium oxide and silica sand. So this is the metallurgical microscopic image of silicon carbide. Next to non-metallic materials, that is glass. Glass is a non-crystalline and inorganic material. So it is a amorphous material, and wide variety range of glass, that is soda lime silica glass for soda bottles to the extremely high purity silica glass for optical fibers. Glasses are widely used in windows, bottles for drinking purpose, household utilities, transfer of piping, and highly corrosive liquids, optical glasses, windows for nuclear applications. The silicon dioxide, that is SiO2, silica is the main constituent of used in the glass. The most common of form of silica that is used in the glass is sand. In sand fusion, temperature to produce glass is 1700 degrees Celsius.
So because the gas is amorphous materials, not a crystalline materials. Gas is a non-crystalline material. And when we add other chemicals to stand, that can considerably reduce the fusion temperature. So here Na2CO3, that is sodium carbonate or soda ash, that will reduce the fusion temperature up to 800 degree Celsius. Other chemicals like calica, that is calcium oxide, magnesia, MgO, that are used for improving the stability of the glass material. And limestone, CaCO3, and magnesium dolomite, that is MgCO3, that are used for this purpose as a source of calcium oxide and magnesium oxide. The main properties of glass are glass ceramic materials that should have a relatively high mechanical strength, low coefficient of thermal expansion, relatively high temperature, and good dielectric property, very good biological compatibility, and thermal shock resistance. These are all the main properties of glass material, and some of the glasses properties and compositions. Glass types are fused silica that contain 96% silica, borosilicate, container, fiberglass, optical, flint, glass, ceramic. So these are used in thermal shock and chemically resistant laboratories, and borosilicate, that is used in thermal chemically resistant laboratory, and container, that can be used in formable and durable, and fiberglass are used in easily drying, and that also used in fiber reinforced plastics. Optical flints, that is used in high sensitivity and high refractive index optical lenses. Glass ceramics are used in thermal shock resistance and also oven wear. And next we move into the non-metallic material, that is polymers. Polymer is the monomer that is used in hydrogen carbon molecules. So each mer that repeat into the unit of HC, the in a monomer, is called polymer. Polymer is again classified into thermosets and thermoplasts. Thermosets often when we heated and harden, finally cooling, because these kind of thermosets polymers are easily reversible. And thermoplastic do not soften on heating. Plastics are moldable into many shape and size, having a sufficient structural rigidity. And plastic is one of the most commonly used glass, most commonly used kind of materials. Natural plastics are rubbers and cellulose, and plastics are used in housing, automobiles, aircraft, packaging, electronics, recreation items, and medical implants. So some of the applications of thermoplastics. Thermoplastics are used in flexible bottles, toys, battery parts, ice trays, film wrapping materials, that is called the polyethylene. Polyamide is the nylon. Material is nylon, that is called polyamide. Polyamide possesses the properties of very good strength and toughness, abrasive resistance, liquid absorber, low friction, low coefficient of friction. Applications of these kind of polyamide are used in bearings, gears, cams, bushings, and jacketing for wires and cables. And next kind of material is Teflon. Teflon is chemically, properties of Teflon are the chemically inert, excellent electrical property, and relatively weak in structure. And these kind of Teflon are used in the anti-corrosive seals, chemical pipes and valves, bearings, anti-adhesive coatings, high temperature electrical components. Next is PET, that is polyester. Properties of polyester are tough plastic film, very good fatigue and tear strength, excellent corrosive resistance. The plastics, applications of usage of plastics are recording tape, clothing, automotive tire cords, and beverage containers. Next kind of material comes under the category of thermoplastics is vinyl. Vinyl properties of vinyl are low cost, general purpose material, rigid one that can be made flexible. And applications of vinyl are floor coverings, pipe materials, electric wirings, electric wire insulations, garden hose, phonographic recordings. Next kind of material, that is polystyrene. Polystyrene properties of polystyrenes are excellent electrical property and optical clarity, very good thermal and dimensional stability. And some of the applications of polystyrene are volatile, battery cases, toys, lighting panels and householding applications. Some properties and applications of common thermosetting polymers, that is epoxy araldehyde. Properties of epoxy are excellent mechanical property and corrosive resistance and very good electrical and very good adhesion and dimensional stability. Some applications of epoxy araldehyde, that is epoxy, is used in electrical molding, sinks, adhesives, protective coatings, fiber reinforced plastics and laminates. And next kind of material is phenolic. It's called as backlight. Properties of phenolic are excellent thermal stability, inexpansive, and it can be compounded with many kind of resins also. Applications of phenolic, that is used in producing motor housings, telephones, auto distributors, electrical fixtures. Next is the aeropole, that is polyester. Characteristics of polyesters are polyester possesses excellent electrical property. Polyester having a low cost one. Polyester is the polyester can be formulated for a room or high temperature. Often it's a fiber reinforced also. And some of the applications of thermosetting polyester are helmets, fiberglass boards, auto body components, and chair fans. And next we look into the category of non-ferrous material and non-metallic material, that is elastomer. Elastomer is one kind of polymer with rubber-like elasticity. And here elastomer, each of the monomer that form a link to form a polymer that is usually made from elastomer made from carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and silicon. The glass transition temperature, TG, is the temperature at which transition from rubber into rigid state that takes place in the polymer. Elastomer are amorphous material, that is amorphous polymer existing in their glass transition temperature. So because of this, primary uses of elastomer are seals, adhesives and molded flexible components. Some of the properties and applications of elastomers are natural. Some materials, that is elastomer materials, are natural rubber, styrene, acrylonitrile, butane, copolymer, chlorophyll. And natural rubber, that is used in pneumatic tires and tubes, heels and soles, and also gaskets. Natural rubber properties are very good temperature range, that is 60 to 120 degrees Celsius, cutting abrasion and resistance to oil and ozone. Next is styrene butane copolymer, SBR. That is properties of styrene butane copolymer are temperature ranges are 60 to 120 degrees Celsius. Good physical property of elongation, that is 450 to 500% of elongation. And this is also used in pneumatic tire tubes, heels, soles and gaskets. Acrylonitrile butane copolymer, NBR. That is properties of NBR, that is excellent temperature range and excellent resistance to oil and elongation. This acrylonitrile butane copolymer NBR, that is used in gasoline, chemicals and oil hose, seals and o-rings, soles and heels. Chlorophyll, that is used in the high temperature insulation, seals, diaphragm, turbine for tubing for food and medical uses. This kind of chloroform uses